Chile has big supplies of lithium and also copper. So I think that that's the main issue, because both minerals are highly demanded for what it's called the energy transition, especially when we talk about electric cars. So we know that electric cars need lithium-ion batteries, but we also know that electric cars need 5 times more copper. And copper and lithium mines are located basically in the same areas. So in the particular case of Atacama, around the salt flats, we have two big copper projects and also two big lithium projects. Lithium mining, it's made out of water in the case of Chile, also Argentina and Bolivia, because this lithium comes from brine, which is very salty water, basically. So the water is extracted from the aquifers, and these aquifers cannot recharge, actually, because these are fossil waters. That means that all the water that is pumped from the underground and it's evaporated to obtain the concentrated brine to get the lithium carbonate goes away, and that affects the superficial waters, like the other waters that are in the lagoons and in wetlands around the salt flat. So that's also affecting the biodiversity. But on the other hand, we also have impact on the local communities that depend on this water and also on these wetlands. Especially in the southern area of Atacama Salt Flat, local communities are struggling to protect the water sources, which are also used for the cattle, mainly llamas or sheep and goats. So the lack of water is affecting, on one hand, biodiversity, and on the other, local activities that somehow are important and fundamental for the livelihood of the communities. I think that local communities should have more participation on the decision-making process about what's being made on their territory. And of course they have the right to be compensated for the damage, the historical damage caused by the state itself, but also by the companies. But this is not enough, because we're not talking only about benefits for communities, we are also talking about biodiversity. So the loss of biodiversity cannot be compensated with any money. And that's very important to understand. Same with water. If the sources of water are exhausted, we cannot recover that with any amount of money. So our organization is the Tanti Foundation. It's a very small NGO. So what we do is work basically on environmental education and create awareness about this subject, but also other subjects related to sustainability, especially in San Pedro and also the north of Chile. So this is also always related to agroecology and the practices that the indigenous communities keep from very old times, and which teach us how to live in harmony with nature, and also how important is the community management of water, for example, the saving of local seeds for food sovereignty, and through the Observatory of Andean Salt Flats, we work with people from Argentina, from Bolivia, people coming from communities, from NGOs, and also from academia. And we focus mostly on the importance that the salt flats, their wetlands, and their biodiversity have, not only for local communities, but also for the world. Because salt flats are very rich in biodiversity, and this biodiversity is very unique. So we think that the salt flats and the communities have much more to offer to the world than only lithium and copper.